the Asian community is full of people who are being really successful. And I think that wasn't always the case. It wasn't always recognised in this country, and it was important that it was. So in the last 15 years, you know, it makes a big difference to a community. But I remember when I was at the BBC and we started the Asian network, you know, the radio network, I remember the launch party for that and just suddenly realising how vibrant this community was. So that's why I came.
And obviously there is still a lack of Asian players and managers. Do you think that's something that the FA can specifically tackle?
Well, I think we'd also like to see more Asian supporters. And a lot of clubs now, I think, in Asian areas are taking that quite seriously. You know, how do you get more Asians to come along to football matches? I think it's, you know, the tradition and the history is not football, it's cricket. But I think there's now more Asian players than there were. But obviously we should try to encourage more people to play.
Do you think that Sepp Blatter's decision to finally step down is going to be a real opportunity to sort out the endemic corruption?
I was this week at a meeting of UEFA for 3 days, and we discussed what do you do about FIFA and what do you do about that. I mean, it is an organisation where corruption has been embedded for 40 years. Now, changing that sort of organisation is quite difficult, but it needs to be changed. There'll be a new, you know, Blatter is going, there will be a new president, but that alone won't change the organisation. You need to have transparency, you need to change the executive, you need to change the way it's run.
I mean, particularly the issue of the World Cup bids, Russia and Qatar, has obviously provoked a lot of debate. Do you think those are decisions that should or must be revisited?
I think if one of the organisations that is investigating that, particularly the Swiss police investigation and the Swiss prosecution investigation, I think if that shows that there was corruption, then they should be rebid, yes.
I mean, how badly do you think the current scandal has affected the reputation of football around the world?
I think people separate football from FIFA. They see FIFA as the World Cup only. And the World Cup was a great tournament. But they all know FIFA is a corrupted organisation. That cannot be healthy. I'm not sure yet that the people within football fully understand the damage of what's gone on this year and how much change they need. So we're one of the groups that are really pushing for change.
Recent high-profile media coverage of the Shed Evans case and the situation with Sheffield United, one of the issues that was often raised was the question about footballers as being role models. Do you think that footballers do have that special significance and as such should be perhaps held to a higher standard in terms of what we expect from them?
Well, their clubs do hold them, I think, often into higher standards. Shed Evans is a different case. It's a quite a complicated argument one way or the other. But I do think clubs now do expect high standards from their players. And certainly if they bring the game into disrespect, we take action. But I think clubs are very good about doing that now. They've realised that it matters to their image that footballers behave properly.
Another issue that football fans were debating for many years before it was introduced was the goal line technology that we now have, of course, in the Premier League. I'm curious, do you think that's something that we'll ever see rolled out to the lower divisions? Because obviously, there was a particular incident in the Blackburn game recently where that would have made a big difference to the result.
You can see the time when it goes to the Championship. I can't see it going below that. It's very expensive. But I also think that we would be greatly in favour of using the more widespread use of television technology and digital technology to help referees. But up to now, that's been blocked by FIFA. I think in the future, there will be changes. Well, we've got a major change programme going through so that we can save £30 million a year. And that £30 million a year we're spending in about 3 or 4 areas, but a lot of it is to do with grassroots football. We have got to get better facilities. We've got to have more all-weather pitches. Government has given us money, we've put money in, the Premier League is putting money in, so we will be able to change that over a sort of 5-year period.